Shalom, Yasharava. First and foremost, we give all praises and honor and glory to Yahawah, Bahashem, YHWH, Bahashem, Rakakadash, the honors to our apostles and elders of Greatmillstone, Ruwil, and peace and blessings to the hopeful elect, pushing us to get gospel and sincerity and truth. This is your brother Tazakiah coming at you another lesson. And it reads, credit card giant MasterCard joins with blockchain digital identity group ID 2020 alliance as world moves closer to the coming mandatory global ID. The ID 2020 alliance was founded by Accenture, Microsoft, Gavi, Rockefeller Foundation, and IDEO. Partners includes NGOs, private companies, and UN agencies. Yesterday, the payments firm MasterCard announced it has joined the ID 2020 alliance to explore digital identity solutions. It says yesterday the payments firm MasterCard now is joining the ID 2020 alliance to explore digital identity solutions. We have been talking for decades about the coming cashless society, one in which buying and selling is controlled by the digital identification mark, and now we are so close to it that is less than 2 years away. NTEB was one of the first very news outlets to warn you back on October 24th of 2019. Now look at this guy. He's trying to take credit for 2019. And our apostles and elders of Greatmillstone have been warning you since they came on YouTube on the scene in 2007. So you need to catch up. And it reads about the company created and funded by Microsoft and Bill Gates, a company called the ID 2020 Alliance. Now credit giant MasterCard has thrown their impressive corporate clout behind them. The process should accelerate exponentially. And I got the scripture. I'm going to get it alone. Lord willing, it reads, all the pieces are falling into place, and the global elites who brought you the global COVID-19 lockdown have many more tricks up their sleeves. All for your protection and safety, of course. Do you know what the very first piece of technology that was released on the market in in the aftermath of 9/11? It was the human implantable RFID microchip from VeriChip Corp. They have since changed their name to Digital Angel. You don't have to wonder what will be released in the aftermath of COVID-19, because we have been showing you and warning you night and day for the last 10 weeks. The only question is, what will you do about it when they come knocking on your door? So most of these people who follow you, especially on the Christianity, y'all ass is going to take it. Now we know a lot of Edomites are not going to take it, but hey, what's the end for you? You're still going to die over here, especially if you're Babylon the Great. And then ultimately in the end, you'll have shackles put on you, as scriptures say, since you guys are so into prophecy, but never seem to mention that. But it goes on to say this, MasterCard joins blockchain Digital Identity Alliance ID 2020. From Ledger Insights, the ID 2020 Alliance was founded by Accenture, Microsoft, Gavi, Rockefeller Foundation, and IDEO. Make sure you guys look into that and see who's the people that own those places. I know you have a few ideas of some of them, but it reads, partners include NGOs, private company, and UN agencies. The ongoing pandemic has led to the emergence of digital-only solutions that require users to prove who they are. Digital identity could play a significant role in facilitating access to a range of digital services. We must work together to establish consistency and common standards. And across Slovakia, common standards across the globe that can make this a reality, addressing real challenges faced by people every day and sparking continued innovation, said AJ Bala, President, Cyber and Intelligence, MasterCard. Last year, MasterCard said it was exploring decentralized digital identity for verifying financial transactions. Government interactions and online services, it is a well-established fact that digital identity could enable banking and other services for people with no physical papers or credit history. And right here is the ID 2020, Mark of the Beast. Everything you know about the ID 2020 and the Mark of the Beast is only a click away, so click it. But, you know, this guy right here just want to take your money from you. So it reads, it says, the World Bank estimates only 1 billion people lack any form of legally recognized identification. This hinders their access to vital services, including healthcare, social protection, education, and finance. Several solutions are being developed globally, but ID 2020 believes collaboration and global partnerships are key to digital identity adoption. Digital identity can be a powerful force multiplier to enhance social and economic opportunities for all people, said Dakota Gruner, executive director of ID 2020, but to fully realize that potential governments, technology companies, financial institutions, and civil society must collaborate. We are delighted to welcome MasterCard to the ID 2020 Alliance and applaud their commitment to private, protecting, user-centric digital identity. Gruner recently penned a Harvard white paper about COVID-19 immunity certificates for Edmund J. Safra Center for Ethics. The ID 2020 Alliance enables partners to pull in funds and other resources to develop digital projects, so like your digital identity projects. The Alliance has already launched pilots and recently worked with the government of Bangladesh to launch a digital identity program for vaccinations in the country. Digital identity has myriad applications, and MasterCard previously joined the Trust Over IP Foundation. Other members of the consortium include Accenture, Evernym, IBM, the DIDX, and R3. Evernym is the company that initiated the sovereign network, the public self-sovereign identity network. South Korea has three separate decentralized identity projects. Last month, Microsoft, Evernym, ID 2020, and many others formed the COVID credential initiative to use digital identity for keeping COVID-19 spread in check. See, and that's when they came out with those apps to track people who so-called get the virus. And it reads, NBC New promoting the mark of the beast as a benefit. Imagine carrying just about everything you need beneath the surface of your hand, your wallet, keys, and ID, all in a microchip. That's reality in Sweden, as some early adopters implant the tiny devices beneath their skin. And then, yeah, everybody in Sweden got their microchip. So here's a few commercials that they got. You got these bug outs talking about the rapture at the bottom. But we understand what this is leading all up to. We should definitely be familiar with this chapter because, hey, this is one of those major things that's pretty much what they've been talking about is about to come up. And as far as what scriptures say, it's definitely going to be one of those end time prophecies. So it reads, this is Revelation chapter 13, verse 15. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as will not worship the image of the beast should be killed. And he calls them all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads. And that no man might buy or sell, say he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. So that's 666, 666. And again, there are consequences for taking this. Because you got some smart asses thinking, oh, I can just take it for a little bit, and then I can buy whatever I need, and I can pull it out. Well, this is what the scriptures say. This is Revelation chapter 14, verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image, and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of YHWH, which is poured out without mixture, into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with the fire and brimstones in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. So if you take this, just know your ass is marked to die. No ifs, ands, or buts. You are going to die. So you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, hey, you need to come back to your power, forsake your wicked ways, and repent so that you may be saved from these perilous times that we are entering. So I hope that this lesson was edifying to any sincere Akim and Akwaf out there listening. I want to give all praises and honor and glory to Yahawah, Bahashem, YHWH, Bahashem, Rakakadash. Double honors to our apostles and elders at Greatmillstone who rule well, and peace and blessings to the hopeful elect, pushing this great gospel in sincerity and truth. Shalom, Yasharallah, Wa, Abai, Babal.